Hello there. So, I bought this iPhone 2G from eBay for $45 with the intent of making one of my famous "Is it obsolete?" videos. Unfortunately, I ran into a problem.
I couldn't get past this screen. When I connected to iTunes, it complained that I didn't have a valid SIM card. After a quick Google search, it was obvious I would have to jailbreak the phone. However, that proved to be an enormous headache, wasting almost an entire day. I read numerous websites that were out of date and typically had broken links for their downloads. I tried watching many blurry amateur YouTube videos describing the process that were hard to follow and often had out of date information, and ultimately was foiled by a constant error message in Red Snow saying USB communication problem on every computer I tried. So I decided to make this up-to-date video for anyone trying to jailbreak an original iPhone, sometimes referred to as the 2G model.
So you might want to make sure that you really have an iPhone 2G. Now the best way to know is just to look at the back. It should be silver at the top and it should have a little black area on the bottom.
Okay, the first step is to download firmware 3.1.2 from Apple. Technically, 3.1.3 is the latest that works with this phone, but I was not able to get that one to work and there's almost no difference. You can get this firmware in many places, just Google for it. Make absolutely sure it's the 2G version. Okay, the next thing you need to do is open iTunes and connect to the phone. Tell it that you want to restore, but hold down the Shift key, or on a Mac, hold down the Option key when you click Restore. This way, it'll ask you for an IPSW file to restore from, and you can locate the one you just downloaded. This will take several minutes, but eventually your phone will reboot, and now you'll be running firmware 3.1.2. Okay, the next thing you'll need to do is download a copy of Red Snow. Yes, it has a 0 instead of an O. However, the newest versions don't work right with the 2G. You'll constantly get this USB communication error that I mentioned before, even though the software clearly identifies the phone. So, what you'll want is the older version 0.9.2.
Okay, so once you get this downloaded, you're going to need to put your iPhone into DFU mode, or sometimes called recovery mode. It's a little bit tricky, and here's how you do it.
Plug your phone into the USB port. First, you turn the phone off by holding down the sleep button until the shutdown option appears. Once it has completely shut down, hold down the sleep button to reactivate the phone and do not release the button. After 3 seconds, press and hold the home button. You should be holding both buttons down at this point. After 10 seconds, release the sleep button but continue to hold the home button for another 5 seconds. Hopefully, you'll be in DFU mode now. If you mess up, just turn the phone off by holding the sleep button for a while and then try it again. Okay, now open Red Snow and click the Browse button. Locate that 3.1.2 firmware you downloaded earlier. Then click Next. If it's the right file, it should say IPSW successfully identified. So it will do its thing for a moment. At this point, you'll have several options to choose from, and I'm not going to go into all of them. In my case, I don't want Cydia since I'm just trying to get into the phone without a SIM card. This unlock option will allow you to use other cell phone carriers besides the default. But again, I don't need that right now. Okay, click Next. It will walk you through putting your phone into DFU mode, but mine was already in that mode, so it'll just go straight through. Eventually, you should see this screen on your phone, which is a good sign that everything's working. Next, you'll see the little pineapple guy while it finishes up. Eventually, it will reboot, and despite the error message about the SIM card, you should finally be able to get into the phone and do whatever you want.
Now, I would like to give one warning when it comes to downloading Red Snow. When I was using a Windows machine, I kept running into downloads that were full of all other kinds of unwanted software, and so it took several attempts before I found just the Red Snow software without getting all the malware and other trial software bundled in with it. So, just a warning on that. Okay, well, I hope you found this video useful. It's probably the only modern, up-to-date jailbreaking video for this older model iPhone that you could probably even find on YouTube. I'm looking forward to making the next video where I'm going to run this iPhone 2G through its paces. I'm going to carry it with me for a week as my own phone, and I'll get back to you with the results, and should be pretty interesting.